Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2252, Unique from Non-Adjacent Columns. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. The other day, I was trying to figure out if there was a way that I could get a unique list of sales rep and product using the new unique function. And after trying for quite some time, couldn't figure it out. All right, but after talking to Joe McDade, Joe gave me an idea, and I do have a way to do this today. Now, first, let's talk about how we would normally do this. All right, so it's sales rep and product. I want every unique combination of those two. Normally, I would come out to data and advanced filter. And a little pre-work here, you have to take the two headings that you want, in this case, rep and product, and copy them out to a new output range. All right, so we go back to our original data, click advanced. It says the data is in A1 to D227. That's great. We're going to copy to another location. The location we're going to copy to has those two headings, and we ask for unique records only, and it returns every unique combination of sales rep and product, which is beautiful. Now, it doesn't sort it, but you know that's just the way it goes, and that's the way that I would have done this, you know, every day up until Excel 2010 came out. Once Excel 2010 came out, then we can copy that data out to a new spot here, and then data, remove duplicates. You always want to make a copy of your data because remove duplicates is destructive, and I only want to base it on sales rep and product. Click OK. All right, same answers that we had back there with the extra column L, just right click and delete, and you'll have your results. All right, but is there some way that we could get a unique list of just B and D using the new unique function? All right, so you know, unique, normally you would specify your data kind of like this, but unfortunately that would give us every unique combination of rep, date, and product. And so is there some way that we can say, hey, look, we just want B2 to B227 and then also D2 to D227, but I couldn't figure out any good way to do that. Now, when dynamic arrays came out, I said it was going to be simpler. We wouldn't have to worry about Control Shift Enter and all the old concepts for dynamic arrays. But it turns out that in this particular case, we do have to turn back to the old arrays. And hopefully by now you've downloaded my book, Excel Dynamic Arrays, Straight to the Point. It's free through the end of the year. And go back to chapter 9, pages 31 and 32. And it talks about the concept of lifting. Lifting is when an Excel function expects a single value, but yet we pass it several values. Even back in the old Excel, it would do all of the calculations. The problem was it wouldn't be able to give us all of the answers. But now, thanks to the ability for Excel to spill answers into multiple cells, it's going to work. All right, so I set up a quick little formula there of RAM between 1 and 2, and you probably are familiar with the choose function. Choose, we send it a single number, and then we say if it's 1, we want apple, if it's 2, we want banana. And depending on whether this is 1 or 2, I'll calculate a couple of times. You see that when the number in R1 is 1, we get apple, when the number in R1 is 2, we get banana. Simple enough, right? Here's what I'm going to do. Instead of passing choose a single function, I'm going to pass it an array of numbers. So I'm going to ask for 1, 2 as an array constant. And that is going to cause choose to lift and to do the choose function twice. So for the iteration where choose is looking at 1, I want to return all the sales rep names, comma. And for the iteration where choose is looking at 2, I want to return all of the product names. So there's our formula. I press enter, and it's going to give me a copy of everything that's over in column B and D, all the way down. Right? That is just beautiful, because now I'm returning a single array that has those two values, and from there it is super easy to get the answer. Here's the unique, like that, press enter, and I get just the unique combination. Still, not sorted like advanced filter would do, not sorted like remove duplicates would do. If you like what you see in this video, please subscribe and ring that bell. All right, now let's just test our understanding here. If I wanted to do a unique combination of three columns, rep, product, and color, I would have to come here to the array that's asking for 1, 2, and I would add a comma 3, And then out here in the choose functions, this is the second argument to choose, the third argument to choose, I would ask for E2 colon E227, like that. All right. And of course, if you needed a fourth one, just add a number 4 and then whichever column you want. And then we press enter, and now a larger array of results because Apple is available in both red, green, and gold. All right, so the answers expand. All right, so we're using something called lifting here. Even though we're using the new arrays, we're still able to lift that, and where choose was expecting a single answer, we're passing it 3 answers, which forces choose to return 3 sets of results. Because these are separated by commas, each result goes in a new column, in essence using a term called broadcasting. All right, now from here, it'd be really nice to be able to sort this. So we just say sort of the whole thing, and then sort wants to know which index do we want. Well, I actually want to sort by all 3 columns. So again, I'm going to do lifting, but this will be pairwise lifting. So I'm going to say sort by columns 1, 2, and 3. And then when it says what's the order, well, I'm just going to go ascending, ascending, ascending. And in this case, because we're passing it 2 arrays that are the same shape, it's going to match up the 1 and the 1, the 2 and the 1, and the 3 and the 1, and should correctly sort this data first by sales rep, within sales rep by product, within product by color, and that all works. Let's just see here if we can kind of finesse this a little bit. Let's sort by column 3 first, and then by column 1, and then by column 2, and we'll make one of these be descending, like that. And so, yeah, we're alphabetical by gold, within the green, it's going descending. So it's not that you have to go in column 1, column 2, column 3 sequence. Now, hey, look, this book, Excel Dynamic Arrays Straight to the Point, is the complete guide to these new arrays. And you'll want to go download this, use the link down there in the YouTube description. This book is free at least through the end of 2018. Probably free until dynamic arrays reach general availability, which will be sometime in 2019. So go download it sooner rather than later. Well, hey, I want to thank Joe McDade for pointing me in a direction there where we could use lifting, broadcasting, and pairwise lifting to solve this problem. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.